good morning. Joining us today from Tirupati Graphite, we have Puruvi Poddar, the head of corporate and business development there, because we've got plenty to discuss after you unveiled your research centre, the progress being made there. This is the Tirupati Graphene and Mintech Research Centre there in India. So hello to you, Puruvi. Maybe give us an introduction to the centre, if you would, the purpose.
Hi, Katie. Lovely to connect. So the Tirupati Graphene and Mintech Research Center is the third leg of our business. Our company is fully integrated into the graphite and graphene space. And what this center brings to us is basically an exemplary center for advanced materials, smart materials, green technologies, and catalyzing the commercialization of graphene. It also brings to us the ability to cater to customer requirements for developing new products using graphite and graphene. So with this announcement that we made on the land allocation, we have received support from the government of Orissa, which is one of the states in India. It gives us access to an area which is the hub for R&D in various mineral technologies, material technologies in the country. And this also provides us a full support and backing of the government of Orissa. So it is quite huge. It's taken us 2 years to get this land allotment. And with this, we have kickstarted the construction of the center itself. We have now started manufacturing the equipments for the graphene processing technologies, which are again in-house developed. We've started procurement activities, we've started the construction activities, etc. So it marks the beginning of a new era for the center.
Excellent, a new era. I like the sound of that. And you have a new addition as well, of course, Dr. Gressel. He has joined your team. Maybe tell us a bit more about him.
Yes, sure. So Professor Gressel is one of the most renowned persons in the world of composites. In fact, I'm his student too. He was one of my professors in the University of Manchester. Mm-hmm. And he's very well connected in the world of composites globally, having worked in various continents. He's now based in the University of Monash. Mm-hmm. He adds to the team, you know, connections into the composite world. And with the kind of graphene that we are making, which is not single layer, but 2 to 3 layers, it opens doors to multiple kinds of industries and applications. So for example, you know, the graphene that we will be making and manufacturing, that will be combined with different kinds of materials, say polymers and metals, etc., to form a new material, which will be better, greener, and will have much higher end properties. Mm-hmm. So that is what Professor Gressel adds to the team.
It's lovely that he was your professor at university. So yeah, you've got a great relationship there. Qualitative improvements. Maybe talk us through this, if you would, with your technical expertise, Puruvi.
Sure. So previously what we had achieved was about 400 to 500 meter square per gram of surface area. With the achievement of up to 1200 meter square per gram of average specific surface area, what this brings us to is that our graphene will have a maximum of 4 layers and with an average of 2 to 3 layers. This again, as we go closer to the 2D scale, the properties of the materials get enhanced. So say for example, the conductivity and mechanical strength improvements that a graphene of 10 layers would have. Compared to that, a 2 to 3 layer graphene will have much, much higher conductivity and mechanical strength properties. So this opens doors to various kinds of industries, and we've chosen a few targets. First is, of course, the batteries and supercapacitors. Graphene has a potential of being infused in the supercapacitors and batteries and improving the quality of batteries. It cannot replace the anode itself, but it can surely add value to it. Second, we are concentrating on polymers and elastomer-based composite materials. So this again opens our doors for, you know, various kinds of applications like automotive industry, acoustics, aerospace, defense industry, etc. Here we add graphene to different kinds of polymers, and Professor Gressel has in fact worked with our graphene in a polymer called Retriever, which is again a self-healing recyclable polymer. So this is the second target for us. third, we are working on a very special application, which is the cathodes that are used in the aluminium industry. So the main, cost component of aluminium processing is the energy consumption. And the energy consumed by a cathode in the aluminium industry is significant. What we are trying to do is actually improve the conductivity of the cathode, which will have a major cost implication for aluminium manufacturers. So we started working on that side. The fourth is making composites of graphene with metals. So with the strength and conductivity that graphene has, you know, initially the first thing that came off was graphene is 100 times stronger than steel. That's all, that's something we all know. So we're trying to get that into commercial materials. With this, you know, we can tap lightweight industries. So applications where fuel consumption increases, if weight increases, we can reduce that. We can increase the longevity of materials with such composites. So again, it opens a lot of doors for us. These are a few things that we're working on. A fifth target for us is coatings. We're working on developing high corrosion resistance coatings for marine applications, defense applications, etc. So with this improved surface area, we've actually been able to, you know, further offer a highly improved quality of graphene to our industrial partners and to various customers that we are working with. And we're sure that will have a huge impact on the quality of product that we achieve at the end.
Excellent. Tirupati Graphite's Puruvi Poddar, the Head of Corporate and Business Development, discussing your new research centre, the Tirupati Graphene and Mintech Research Centre there in India. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Katie.